Hi guys, welcome back to the tutorial. If you're building Next.js app with Tailwind CSS, you are gonna love this. There is a tool called Shadcn UI that's been gaining a lot of traction for a good reason. It gives you a full set of UI components styled with Tailwind and super accessible and best for all. You actually own the code. You don't install it as a traditional package. Instead, it literally gives all of the source files right inside into your project, so you can tweak all of the styles for your own needs. In this video, I'll show how exactly and what Shadcn UI is and why it's such a powerful tool compared to other traditional component libraries and how to integrate it with Next.js. Also, I'll show how to integrate with Figma and use AI tools in order to convert designs into your code within just a minute. So, alright, let's break it down. So, Shadcn is a collection of accessible, headless, and fully customizable UI components. It's built using Tailwind CSS and Radix UI under the hood. So there is a key difference between the other traditional component libraries. So as it states within the documentation, that this is not a component library. So it basically means that it's not going to be installed using npm and imported with pre-compiled components. Instead, Shadcn UI is actually component is going to give you a component code so that you can edit them, delete them as you don't need. So all of your code is going to live within your project. So this approach is more convenient than the most of the libraries because you're not stuck with a rigid API or optionated styles within your project. So everything lives within your repo, is predictable, editable, and easy to maintain. So let's get started and try to implement this within our Next.js project. So let's try to integrate Shadcn into our project. For that, I'm going to go to docs and run npm shadcn init within my project. This is going to initialize me our Shadcn config within our project. So this is going to ask us the basic colors, which is going to be our several options from this. So this can be neutral, gray, zinc, stone, or slate. If you are not sure which color to choose from, you can go over to colors within the documentation and go over to browse colors documentation, and there is a browse colors tab. So this is all of the reference list within which exists within the themes. You can test all of these colors for your own choice. I'm going to go over to the neutral, so which is going to be white, black, and the gray color if I'm not sure. Since we are using React 19, we can use force or legacy peer devs for our installation of our Shadcn. So this is completely safe for now, and over time, React 19 is going to be stable over time. For your case, it can be stable already. For now, this is completely safe to use force for now. And I'm going to go to force. So success. Now our Shadcn is initted within our project. This is going to give us a component JSON, which is going to include all of the configs for our Shadcn, including our base colors and all other options, so that our components is going to be stored within the components folder. And all of the UIs, all of the utils, libraries, and the hooks that are included as a folders within our config. So all styles also are New York, and you can our Tailwind is going to be stored within the CSS file and much more. So also it included within our global CSS. If you can find it within the global CSS, it already included all of the colors which we already selected. We have selected the neutral color, so it included all of the base colors within our global CSS, which is going to be later used within our components. So let's try to install our first component, which is going to be our button. So for that, I'm going to copy this line of code, which is going to give us the button. Let's copy it, let's paste it. So let's clear our terminal and let's run this command, which is going to add button for us, but you can select any component that's included within Shadcn, whether it's import or text area or any other component that's included within this documentation. So all of the components are included within the documentation, which is going to be accordion, alert, or any other component that's included within the list. So you can also copy all any npm cl npm in order to install it. So let's run this command. So it also is going to also, we are going to use the force rule, so this is completely fine to do so. Now I'm going to run my development, and within my page I'm going to include this component. So let's try to remove all of the default page from Next.js and let's try to put our button, which is going to be from the components UI button, and let's call this asset button. Now if I go over to my localhost, I'm gonna see my button within my page, which is going to be a styled component from Shadcn. Now here's where things get really interesting. If you're working with a designer or use Figma yourself, you can use Shadcn UI plugin within Figma. So it will let you select a component within the design and instantly generate a matching code within using Shadcn UI. So you can literally go from Figma to production ready code within in a minute. So it's an absolute game changer when you want to, when you're working with as a designer to dev handoffs. But keep in mind, it's not free. You will need to use paid plan to utilize these advanced tools like Figma plugin and AI power generator. Now I have already authentication design within my Figma, so I would like to instantly generate Shadcn UI code for my project. For that, I'm going to enable the dev mode for Figma and go over to your plugins. Initially, it's going to look like this, and you are gonna search for Figma to Shadcn UI plugin. Then you are gonna input your Anthropic and license key in order to use using paid plan, and I've already inserted my license key and Anthropic key. Then I'm going to generate code for this current frame, which is going to be my authentication page. And keep in mind that if your colors are completely different from your Figma design within your project, you can go over to your manage variables and export all of the CSS files and paste all of these CSS files into your global.css. So then, now I'm going to go over to generate code and going to generate this frame, which is going to be an authentication page. And keep in mind that if you have the mobile version of your page and you can select this design within the mobile frame and click plus button, which is going to select the mobile version for this current page. So then it's going to be responsive for within your Next.js project as it appears within the design. So let's try to copy the code and paste within my home page, and as you can see, I have absent components within my Next.js project. So let's try to install all of these components. For that, I'm going to write npm shadcn latest add input and separator. let's wait a little bit, and I'm going to use the force rule as before. And let's try to run our dev mode and go over to our project. So as you can see, we've generated all of the authentication page using AI generator within a minute using Figma design. But of course it's not perfect, but I think it mainly solves all of the bottlenecks of the frontend developers, that you don't have to type all of the Tailwind CSS completely from scratch. So you can already work using all of this generated code and work on top of it. So you can use this AI generation and generate all of these designs within a minute and solve all of your and simplify your workflow. Also, you can open it within V0, which is going to be an AI generation, and which is going to give you a preview mode for your code, and this is going to give your actual code. And as you remember, V0 uses the Shadcn library in order to generate some user-friendly UI, and on top of it you can utilize V0 if you don't have any design at all within the Figma. So keep in mind that you can use V0 to generate any designs within your application. So you can play around with the preview mode or use this code in order to simplify your workflow. Thank you for watching. If you find Shadcn UI simplify your workflow, don't forget to hit like button and subscribe to this channel. I've got more content coming to help to simplify your workflow. And stay tuned, and I will see you in the next one.